Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Ridler Studios. I'm Jamie. It is Tuesday. I'm going to have to get used to saying that. And it's the first show of the fall season. Yay! I am just so excited to be back. I know many of you probably expected me back yesterday. If you got the newsletter, if you're a member of the studio, which I hope you are, and if you're not, head on over to openthedoor.ca and join. You'll know that I am going to be working with a new schedule this season, and the BTS is going to be here on Tuesdays and Fridays. So only two times a week, but we're still going to have, I really wanted to keep Friday in there, and Shannon helped me figure out a schedule. Thanks, Shannon, to make that happen, because it feels like such just the right way to finish off the week and a great time for show and tell, though I am going to have some show and tell for you today. So how was the rest of your summer? How was August? How did it treat you? What did you create? What was the energy that you were basking in as you completed the season? We still have about 10 days before we officially move into the next season, so there's still time to make sure you get some of the seasonal pleasures that you enjoy in. One of the things I always do in the academy, and that's where all the classes are for the studio, is each season I have a calendar that has all of the classes and their descriptions and a little welcome, a little explanation of how things work in the studio. And I also wrap it up with a series of journal questions that help you gather all the joy and experiences, all the wisdom, all the learnings from the season that you're leaving, and then also get you grounded in visioning for the season that is ahead. So if you're interested in doing that journal practice, go on over again to openthedoor.ca, click on the academy, and there you'll see the owl who and a download button for the calendar for the classes, but also in that are these questions to close off the season that's passed and be open to the season ahead. This, for me, right now, feels like an incredibly transformational time. All around me are signs and signals that some deep change is happening. Is that the kind of thing you tune into too? Those kind of synchronicities, those kinds of moments that where you feel like there's the details of reality, but then there's the something underneath, the symbolic meaning, the intuitive meaning, the meaning, the message from the universe that's coming in and giving you a little tap on the shoulder. And yesterday, many of you who've been with me for years might know that I have a tree that is my companion. There, I look out the window and there's this big and beautiful tree. You've probably also seen it from pictures outside the studio window. And it's actually on our neighbor's property, but it is my daily friend. And yesterday she got a major, major, major trimming. And it's good. It's good. It's healthier for her. It's safer for us. But it's also change. So I have a bit of sadness about it too. Last night, I heard this blue jay calling with real aggressiveness. And it brought home to me that perhaps a lot of wildlife has lost a home last night. That their nests may be gone. Their protection of all those branches and leaves may be gone. Squirrels may have been displaced. Raccoons may have been displaced. And they'll have to make an adjustment to this new world. And there was a rawness that I heard in that call. And all of that happened on the day that is also the first day back in the studio for me, the first day of a brand new schedule, so things are changing, the first day back in this environment that feels transformative. And I was like, ah, tree, you and I are on this journey. Things in my space, life, the studio, things will change. Things will be displaced. Things will feel raw. Things will feel new. Things will open up. And there's some discomfort in that. But I also take great inspiration from the fact that ultimately, when I look out the window at the tree, she seems stronger. She's standing tall, she's standing proud, and she seems stronger. And so I'm taking that as a message for me, that as I clear, that I will be stronger too. And I always like to share those metaphors and those happenings, because so often I find the energy isn't just with me, that the energy is something that is happening in the community, that is something that is happening energetically. And perhaps that's happening for you too. You're feeling like things are transforming and you're watching things need to get cleared away, and maybe not feeling that comfortable with it. Maybe it being in a state of mourning about what you're losing. And this idea that once we go through that difficult stage, we can emerge stronger, is something that I'm feeling and something that I want to pass along to you too. One of the things that's changing the studio. So two things. One, the BTS changing to Tuesday and Friday. And two, that some of you will have seen, I've written a post about me taking my blog back. I feel so good about this, and I felt so trepidatious at first. I really miss the days of community blogging. I miss the days of just regular life showing up on the blog, of shared recipes and 10 things you might not know about me and community memes. And I miss the honesty and authenticity of it. And yes, I love beauty and magic and when we see something. And I love websites like that. I love it when I take a photograph and it evokes that in me and I think, I did that. You know, I love that if you take a class with me, I hope that you step into the classroom and you feel embraced by a beautiful environment. I hope that it's like when you do a show in the theater. There's all different spaces and all different stages. There's around the table readings, and there are messy and brave and risky rehearsals, and there are wonky tech rehearsals where lots goes wrong. And then there's the magic of putting on the show, of it being live. And all of those energies are a part of our creative life. So there's things, if I put out a course, if I create a book, you know, I want it to achieve that magic. But there needs to also be a place for a little more like loose conversation, a little more hanging out, a little more like gathering before we even start to work. And I want to bring some of that to the blog. And so I am braving it. So far, the response has been amazing. I thank you so very much for that positivity, because one of the things that's true about making change, not only is it just uncomfortable inside of you. You know, I've started this new schedule and I'm so excited about it, but still yesterday felt weird because I wasn't doing things the way I do things. So there's an adjustment period. So, but that doesn't just happen in here. It happens in out here too, as people respond to what your choices are, to the changes that you're making. We all kind of like to get settled in. We all like kind of anticipating what's going to happen next. We like being in the know. And when somebody around us changes, it kind of makes us have to change too. So maybe you're used to watching the BTS Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and you're like, Amy, what are you doing? What are you doing? But hopefully you'll like some of the other things that come up and are possible because of this renewed spaciousness. One of the reasons I've done it is it's going to make it easier for me to keep the podcast going, because then I really have three of these recording things to do a week instead of four, which was getting tough. And also I'm ready, like I'm really ready to be doing some writing. And I know I've been talking about writing a book for a long time. I have lots of books to write, but right now in this moment, I am ready to be writing, and I need to make some space for that. And one day, I hope you'll all really enjoy what I have to share. So change can be good and healthy, and we mustn't be afraid of it. And we must be able to trust our instincts. So this was my gut saying something needs to adjust, and I may not know exactly what it is. I'm willing to risk trying something. I'm willing to risk trying something in public. I'm willing to adjust it if it doesn't work. So I guess the theme we're starting off this fall with is newness, you know, being willing to start fresh. For many of us, September is a fresh start. It's kind of ingrained in our system. And in fact, I believe every season can be a fresh start. So if you were trusting your gut, trusting your instincts about what you wanted in the season ahead, instead of just continuing to do what you've been doing, instead of just doing September the way you do September, but if you just took a moment to check in with yourself and asked yourself, what do I need this season? What would be awesome to do, to experience, to create, to share this season? What have I been dreaming of that never seems to happen? This is a key conflict between our dreams and our daily reality, you know, is that our daily reality may not be supporting what we dream of. So if you've got a dream that just never seems to get off the ground, but also never leaves you, then how could you create this season? What could be your routine, your schedule, the way you spend your time, the way you prepare? How could you shift that, create that, so that just maybe it could send some energy in the direction of that dream? What does that dream need in order to start coming alive? I guarantee you, when you start to do that, you will start to come alive too. So speaking about dreams and energy and good stuff, I have some things I want to share. So first of all, you may have already been admiring this. Can you see my necklace? Let's see if I can get a little closer. Can you see it? For those of you who have, you know, who are familiar with the studio, what do you think this is? The studio kittens. So this is three beautiful stones with set in silver with three sets of ears, and one is gray and two are black. So we have Escher and Scout and Shibumi. Or I think it's probably Escher, Shibumi, and Scout. I knew it as soon as I said it. And this was made for me by a wonderful creative man, a silversmith named James Thompson. James, I am so moved beyond words at this gracious gift, this beautiful creation, and I am so thankful. And I don't think that James has a silversmithing site yet or an Etsy store or anything like that, but let's encourage him to do that. But I just wanted to really send a shout out to James for this beautiful creation. And how perfect, because we are starting this season with, can you see our empty bulletin board? It is ready for the BTS Bulletin Board Art Challenge this season. Our theme this season is cats. And so please send me some art that you've made yourself that is cat related. Be sure to sign it, and you can send it to my P.O. box. I will always have the P.O. box at the end of the video, and I promised that the very first cat that came in would be our cat mascot for the season, and it has arrived from Leonie. So let me show you the cats. We've got our first pieces of bulletin board art. I'm so excited. Thank you, Leonie. Leonie is in British Columbia. Here in Canada. She's included the date, she signed it, and on the back she also put what she used to create this. So Tombow's Prismacolor pen and a Uniball Signo. Here we go, here's the first one. Oh, and she's written a haiku. Circle Kitty sleeps with one eye open, waiting for my soft, warm lap. Oh, it's awesome. So we got some poetry in there too. I've really been discovering how many poets we have in this community, and I'm just loving that too. And here's the other one: watercolor, Unibalsigno, Prismacolor pen, and white gouache. Don't forget to smell the flowers. Thank you so much, Leonie. So I'm going to choose one of these kittens to be our mascot for the season, and you will always be able to see him or her at the end of our video along with my P.O. box, where you can send me your cat bulletin board art. I cannot wait to see what you create. Last season, we had an amazing garden of flowers by the end of the season, so I'm really looking forward to an impressive collection of creative cats from you creative cats. That gave me the little like beatnik vibe there. I hope you'll hang out with me on Tuesdays and Fridays and check out the Creative Living with Jamie podcast on Thursdays. You can find it on iTunes. And sometime in the next 2 weeks, I'm going to do either a YouTube live or a Facebook live or both for a bit of a Q&A about the classes that are in the Academy. So if you want to know, well, what is Journal Club actually like? Or why do we dream under the full moon? Or any other questions you might have about classes over at Jamie Ridler Studios, that would be a great time to ask me. Of course, you can ask me anytime. You can email me at Jamie, J-A-M-I-E, at openthedoor.ca. You can ask me in the comments about classes at the Academy. But I thought it would be fun to have an opportunity to be live and be responsive to whatever questions you might have. So remember, hop on over to openthedoor.ca, join the studio if you haven't, check out the Academy, download the calendar, and let those journal questions really help you close off the last season and feel ready for the amazing season that's to come. Let's do this. I will see you on